Welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Indigo Prophecy. I'm your host, Heike. So this time we're gonna go with Lucas Kane to his apartment. Don't worry, we're not gonna do anything funny. We're just gonna go there. How are you doing, Lucas? Whoa. I guess I should take the door. Okay. I mean, pick up the phone.
Lucas Kane.
Master Nartilan Katanekli Courtney Plan Nikan Master Apari Oni.
You guessed it. We're gonna be attacking the house. I mean, the house is gonna be attacking us. Get ready. Yeah, this is a pretty hard one. I died, that first time I did this, I died quite a lot. So, I'm gonna try my best not to die. I know it is impossible, but either way, I'm trying. That's right, boxes and everything. It's going across the window and all that stuff. This is gonna be interesting. Attacking us! Why? It's that hooded guy again. And you thought this episode was gonna be action free. This is where the life system is very, very helpful. If you get hit one time or mess up one of these QTE things and stuff, your life gets, well, one of your life gets, you know, subtracted. And if you lose, like, if you lose all your life, then you gotta do the whole thing over and over again. And by over, I mean, okay. Just keep on doing it. Yes, ready. Tired. All the left and right things. Man. You'll expect, I mean, eventually you'll see me pause the game, just, you know, catch up with strength and all that. Oh god. Okay, I didn't use a, I don't think I used a, you know, a lifeline or whatever lifelines these things are. So, anyway. But I'm gonna try not to have, I mean, I'm gonna try and have less of these breaks. I mean, less of those breaks that I was talking about. Yeah. Sweaty hands do not help. Great, great. Oh no, the couch is after me! My apartment, it's not an apartment anymore. It's not connected to that building. It's connected to the left side. Okay. Stupid folks. You're trying to kill me? Cash. Oh no, the TV! No, my kitchen! What are you doing to my kitchen? Oh, my stereo set. All my favorite music songs are in there. the controller is rumbling like hell. Oh no, man, this is not real. I'm dreaming. To survive that.
Lucas's terrifying story haunted me all night long. I had to see him, to talk to him. I had to find out what Agatha had told him. I wanted to look my brother in the eye and hear the truth. I'd never been to his apartment before, and it took me some time to find it.
That's a pretty cool elevator. Oh no, man. Lucas, your apartment is fine. So you kind of have to find out...
Lucas Kane. That's it.
Oh, wow, okay. I guess looking out the window of the door thing really helped, because you get to know that it's in a hallway, not in... Oh, no.
Lucas? Lucas, open the door! Lucas!
I kind of forgot there was a bonus card around here.
I could swear that I heard a scream coming from inside. The doorman said Lucas was at home, but he isn't opening. Lucas is in danger. I've got no other choice.
Yep, there's more left and rights. Okay, great. I have no idea how I did that. See? Everything's in place. I didn't lose this. I didn't lose my TV or my couches or my kitchen, for the matter. Man, I need a kitchen to move. Lucas!
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 Oh my god! That's how my story ends. Officially, they called it a suicide. I'd never find out the truth about what really happened to me in that restaurant on that cold January night. I'd never know who it was that killed me.
Yeah, that's what happens if you fail at least one of those things. You know, the long thing. I know, this is pretty unreal, really. Okay, well, at least I get to... If you fail one of those things, then you're done for, really. That's weird. I should have known there was a bonus card around here. I may have been wrong.
The tenants' names are on the bells. No, Lucas doesn't live here.
Lucas lives around here somewhere, okay. Never mind, I guess there wasn't a bonus card, but at least you've got a taste of what happened and if you fail...
Lucas Kane. That's it.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy how, you know, one screw up and he's over. He has his monologue of what happens in the end.
Lucas? Lucas, open the door! Lucas! I could swear that I heard a scream coming from inside. The doorman said Lucas was at home, but he isn't opening. Lucas is in danger. I've got no other choice.
He's inside. Lucas! Hang on!
Lucas! Oh my god! And that's how my story
ends.
Oh my
god!
Officially, they called it a suicide.
I know, please. Stop saying it.
Yes,
I know, man. Wow, such a screw up. It sounds so hard. I figured it out, really. Okay, whatever. I'm just gonna go straight ahead then.
Lucas Kane. That's it.
This ain't supposed to happen so many times. God. Yeah, I know. I said I flunked that, you know, apartment trying to kill me thing, but this should be so hard, really. Ugh.
Lucas? Lucas, open the door! Lucas!
Yeah, I'm supposed to save it.
I heard a scream coming from inside. The doorman said Lucas was at home, but he isn't opening.
Okay.
Lucas Lucas is in danger. I've got no other choice.
I figured it out. You are supposed... Okay, you are not supposed to stop for anything. You're supposed to keep on doing it. And
Lucas!
Yeah,
keep on doing it. Oh my god!
Yeah! That's how you do it. That's how you save your brother. That is how you save your brother.
Lucas, for God's sake, have you lost your mind? What's come over you? The walls were blown away, and the wind, the tempest, why did you do this, Lucas? Why? Somebody tried to kill me. For heaven's sake, Lucas, there's no one else here but you and I. You were all alone when I arrived. All alone, Lucas. What's happening to me, Marcus? I don't know what's happening. It'll be all right, Lucas. Everything will be fine. I'm gonna help you. You'll see.
Thanks, bro. You're saving me 3 times. Yeah, I screwed up 3 times. It's pretty pathetic of me, but whatever. At this place. Don't worry! I'm pretty sure. Yeah. You didn't see those. Don't worry about it. You didn't see anything. Hopefully this does not get marked at all. Pretty simple. But that's how. Oh yeah, pretty simple. yeah, so we're in Carla's place now. We just finished taking a bath and you should get that telephone. Oh no, that's pretty loud. Anyway. It should be in the living room. This is my... yeah. This is, look at all my stuffed animals. Hello.
Sure took your time.
I was in the shower. What do you got?
I got nothing. Dead end. Impossible to ID the page marker found in the book from the restaurant. It's got a series of numeric codes written on it. But it just looks like a lot of numbers to me. I thought you might have some ideas.
Why don't you fax it to me? I wasn't tired anyway. I'm sure it'll make for good bedtime reading.
Okay, I'll send it now. If you get any brainstorms, give me a ring. I'll be here for a while. Tonight's gonna be a long one.
Okay, talk to you later, Tyler.
You seem slightly back. Yeah. So this is actually a little two-part mission here. We're gonna do whatever Carly needs to do with her apartment, and munchy munchy. That gave me 5 mood points. Yay. Once again, I'll be sure to credit the music. This music is pretty good. It's like, I don't know, my favorite tune, I suppose. Apart from the original soundtrack I don't know how to say those, but... Sad baby kisses. So this is my home computer. Okay, let's look at our mail. Valium! Up to 60% reduction on Valium when you order online today! Receive more than 300 tons of tranquilizer delivered. Yeah, okay, I'm not interested. It's from Tommy. And the subject is hit. Hi, Carla. I'm sorry I wasn't able to give you any news for a while. I've been very busy with my job. I'll drop by your place as soon as I can to tell you about my latest adventures. Lots of kisses! Tommy. Yeah, that should, like, you know, get you wondering who this Tommy is. Like, why is he sending so much kisses to Carla here? I mean, yeah. And some stuff about things. Oh, look, they mentioned David Cage, the French director of this game. Either way, it's cool. Yeah, it's from news. Weather, cold wave makes new victims. Yeah, it's getting really rough. Snowstorms, everything. Ohio, 200 trucks are still stuck in the side of the road. Okay, the world. Pakistan, the ultimatum ends today. La 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 la. Something. I think it's the same story as before. But yeah, in case you guys haven't noticed, something about the world. This famous dude. Wow, I'm making a crazy joke for myself. Man, I was listening to it in the news. How can I not remember his name? He died. What was that dude's name? Yeah, I'm pausing the game just to remember. Osama bin Laden. Yeah, man, that kind of slipped off my mind in time. Yeah, he died. I have no idea who killed him. And yeah, that has something to do with... Okay.
How could that be at this hour? Not expecting anyone.
Yikes, I should put some clothes on. I'm not gonna meet Tommy Wood like this. Let's put some clothes on. Well, her hand is being morphed into the dresser. So there's light. Alright, yay. I dress like I'm going to work. Hi there.
I was feeling kind of bored, and thought as my official friendly neighbor you'd agree to share my boredom. And this excellent bottle of friendship lead.
In my capacity as your friendly neighbor, I wouldn't think of refusing your boring invitation or your excellent wine, Tommy.
I imagine that even a die-hard bachelorette like yourself must have some wine glasses around here somewhere.
I think I do have some. Somewhere. Sit down, Tommy. I'll find them.
Somewhere? This is your apartment! You're supposed to know where those wine glasses are! Don't worry, she hasn't had any drugs, so she's not gonna get poisoned. By drugs, I mean... pills, antibiotics, fever things, I don't know. Yeah. You'd be searching everywhere, but... Oh, never mind. I happen to know where the glasses are. Okay. Yeah, there they are. I think I got some Chinese food in there.
A toast?
All right. What to?
To love. What else?
I'll drink to that.
In case you haven't noticed, this dude's Tommy. He has to be Tommy. Yeah, I think he did mention him as Tommy. Or later, he mentioned him as Tommy. Yeah, so Tommy.
Are you with anyone?
Well, actually, I did meet someone 2 weeks ago. He's very real and very nice. And he works in a bank, too. I think this time it could turn into something serious.
Yeah, Tommy's gay.
I'm happy to see you got your smile back.
Difference.
We all have our ups and downs, right? I always thought that people in New York didn't give a damn about gayness. They were so enlightened. How wrong I was. They still look at us as being different from so-called normal folks. Are you still single? What's a beautiful girl like you waiting for? Go find yourself a nice guy. If there's one thing New York has lots of, it's handsome men.
I don't know. I guess the desire is just not there. My last romantic experiences were total disasters. I'm not ready for anything. Or anyone just yet.
Yeah.
Enough small talk. Look at what I brought.
Tarot cards?
I'm going to read your future.
You mean you know how to use those things?
My grandmother was a psychic. She taught me how to read the cards when I was just a kid. She handed down her seeing powers to me. It really works, you know. What the cards foretell always come to pass. Let's see if you're going to meet your true soulmate or if you're going to die as a wrinkled old maid.
Okay, Mr. Gypsy. Tell me what I'm supposed to do.
You shouldn't call them gypsies,
it's easy. First, take the cards and mix them up.
Let's do it. Just a with fury. The poster behind it.
Take two cards.
That's right. Take something. Wow, those are... You sorted them pretty well. Okay, so here it says, left thumb stick to move, eight or choose to tarot card. Pretty, yeah, something. Let's do this one. Okay, whatever that is. What's this?
There's going to be a dark period, an escape, and terrible danger. Take two more cards. Following someone, and he is disturbing. He hides a heavy secret. Take two more cards, please.
Whoa, that doesn't look really nice, but okay.
There is a curse. Great suffering and fear. I see dark death and distress. Yes, just come to me whenever you need cheering up. Seriously, I'm sorry, Carla.
What?
This is not turning out to be as much fun as I thought.
It's okay, Tommy. Let's see what horrors my destiny holds for me. Here are two more cards.
Okay, two more cards. Let's do this. Oh, okay, I met someone. Okay, what's this?
One child. Two destinies, a path toward life, the other path toward death. Carla, I think we'll stop there. I'm sorry, I don't know what happened. It's the first time I've ever read this sort of thing in the cards. Usually don't express anything like this.
Don't apologize, Tommy. It's just a silly game. I never believed in fortune-telling anyway.
Well, I've got to get home. It's late. Good night, Carla.
Good night, Tommy. It was real nice talking. Yeah. Don't wait so long next time, okay?
I promise.
You forgot your tarot cards in your coat. Yeah, he lives right across, and I'm not really sure what's that thing on the door. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's kind of strange. Is there something I'm supposed to do? Well, okay. I'm 65% stressed. Oh, that's sad. Yeah, at least I still have four lives. Yahoo! 30% done with the story. Alright, so...
Is my future that grim? You mentioned a child. I don't believe in this stuff, but it's always a little scary, whatever you think of it.
Mentioned a guy. You also mentioned a guy. Basically. I'm supposing we should end... Because it's going a little bit over time. Next time on Let's Play Indigo Prophecy, I'm supposing we're supposed to go with Tyler now, because he has some things to do. And they gave us the option to press B to go with Tyler, so... Yeah, that's what we're gonna do next time. I'm making so many videos now. Until next time, see you then.